The pictures you see there are the Foundation Stone Children's Center in Bondo, Siaya County. And once in a while, we like to feature guests, visitors to this country, hopefully to make us feel good about ourselves. Good evening, I'm Jeff Koinange, and this is Jeff Koinange live at the Villa Rosa Kempinski on this Inspirational Thursday. Once in a while, we do need inspiration. Once in a while, it's good to look outside of this country to get some inspiration. So, this is how the story goes. Some 4 years ago, young teenagers from Jacksonville, Florida, led by a young lady by the name of Chelsea Kane, decided to come to Kenya. Why? Because they had been sponsoring a young orphan at that orphanage you saw there, the Foundation Stone Children's Center, and they wanted to see for themselves what the place was like. So she gathered 19 of her colleagues, 20 in total, flew to Kenya, went to Bondo, bonded in Bondo with the kids. 4 years later, they're still coming back, despite the fact that now they are college kids at the tender age of 21. Listen up, folks. Not only do they keep going back to that orphanage, now they want to build a center. Why? Because they use theater to express themselves. Theater to give kids a feeling of being human, for lack of a better word. That's what they do. They call themselves Theater on a Mission. They raise funds on their own in America, come to Kenya to help these little kids. So the question is, while students and pupils are burning schools across the country, why is it that these people would come all the way to help build schools? Think about that as we talk to my young guests, Chelsea Kane,
hi,
Danielle Glenn,
hi.
Jackie Jones,
hi.
And Craig Kane.
Howdy.
Did I get the names right?
Yes. Yes.
Somebody say, oh my.
Oh my.
Twitter handles are at Theater_Mission.
Yes.
Did I get that? At Koinange Jeff, we're using the hashtag giving back, because that's what these young folks are doing, literally giving back. Chelsea, so take me back. You're 16 years old, and you decide, well, you've been sponsoring this little kid in Africa somewhere, 8,000 miles away, and you decide you want to go and see where this kid lives or what this kid, you know, where this kid comes from. Right. What do you do? What did you do?
Aisha at the orphanage that we work with, and we were writing letters back and forth, and I just had this really strong, overwhelming desire in my heart to go visit her. And as a theater student, that's something I knew I could share with her and all of her friends at the orphanage, because theater has brought a lot of joy and has done a lot in my life, and I knew I could share that with her and all of her friends at Foundation Stone.
Yeah. What was it like convincing? Okay, Danielle, so Chelsea comes to you and says, look, we're going to Africa. Oh, is that what she said?
Oh, yeah, that's exactly what she said. I, as her friend, I said, okay, well, what are we going to do? So, but we were able to collaborate with one another and develop this theater camp that we could bring to, you know, not only one child, but multiple children. And it blossomed from there.
Yeah. None of you had ever been to Africa before?
No.
So, Jackie Jones, so you arrive in Nairobi, Kenya.
Yes, sir.
What was that like, and then heading to Bondo?
Well, I came on the second trip in 2014.
Okay.
And that was because of Shelly Kane told me in the hallway that I was coming with her to Africa. And I was like, okay. And just getting here was so surreal. I never thought it would happen. It was never in my mind that I would end up going to Africa and coming back and wanting to move here one
yeah.
day.
Do you fall in love with it?
Definitely.
Absolutely,
really?
Yeah.
Yeah. Craig, you too?
Yes, sir.
First feeling, you arrive in Bondo. It's not Jacksonville, Florida.
Well, at first, I didn't believe it. I was like, no, you know, we're not here, whatever. And then one day, like, in the middle of the night, I just wake up and go, we're in Africa. Like, we're here, and we're doing this, so.
Yeah, yeah. So, Chelsea, your first time in Africa, mm-hmm. 8,000 miles away.
Yeah.
What was going through your mind? Were you nervous? Were you scared? I mean, you must have heard all kinds of stories.
Yes, it was definitely a mix of emotions. A little bit of nerves, definitely scared going to a new place I've never been before, but definitely most excited. I was so excited. I couldn't even contain myself because I was just so excited.
Were any of you scared?
Girl.
You know, you heard stories, you know, Al Shabaab, you heard, you know, you must have heard a bunch of stories.
I was scared. Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And it was a really big shock, honestly. Like, driving around and seeing, you know, the countryside and, like, how some people live.
Yeah.
I definitely think it was a shock for me.
Yeah. A lot of poverty, too, let's face it.
Absolutely. Yes. Yeah. We were, you know, and that's not something we're used to being surrounded by, you know, every day. We see it, but it's definitely intensified when we come here. And that was a shock for us, but it was also very humbling for us and inspiring.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, Jackie, you encounter the kids at the orphanage. At the center.
Instant tears every single time. They're just so full of life, and every time we pull into the orphanage doors, they run up to the bus and they're so ready to greet us and see us again, and it's just amazing.
Yeah. Chelsea, this Aisha you talked about, is she still alive? She's still there?
Yes.
At the center?
She's actually at secondary school right now, but she's still involved with the orphanage.
Yeah. And look, what do people in America think of you all coming here, young Americans?
We have so much support back home.
Do you?
We do.
They think you're doing a good thing?
Yes.
You think you're doing a good thing?
Absolutely.
What's the best thing?
The best thing? The kids.
Yeah?
The kids.
Yeah.
The children.
And you all keep coming back, Danielle. I mean, you're in college now.
Oh, yeah.
You guys graduate next year.
Next year.
And you want to move here full time.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Are you kidding me?
No. We're going to be here. This is our second home, and we figured that out after the first trip. And we knew that, you know, after that, this was going to be a permanent thing. And we're all committed to Theater on a Mission, and we can't wait to see how it's going to grow and how it's going to change lives. So
okay.
We're in this for the long run.
Mm. Tell me how Theater on a Mission works. What exactly do you do?
Well, we take a theater camp to the orphanage, and we also do a one-act play. And so we do a week-long theater camp with the students in the morning, and then in the afternoons, we do rehearsals for the play. And so we work with them for a week and a half, and just explore the arts. It helps them with their confidence, their self-esteem. It breaks the cultural barrier, and it gives them such a creative outlet. And so that's really what we push for, is for them just to create.
Yeah. Craig, they don't even speak English over there. How do you all communicate?
See, that's what the joy of theater does. It breaks down that barrier that languages, you know, build. And so when we play these games and we spend time with them and we be their role models, It just opens up like a whole, it's hard to explain, but it opens up a whole new side of someone that you can't really see unless you do what we do.
Yeah. So, all these kids are orphans,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Abandoned orphans.
No,
I mean,
no mother,
eight,
no father.
Right. No mother, no father. Mm-hmm. Have you seen them change, Jackie? Have you seen them develop over the years?
Definitely. Each time, I feel like every time we do the camp, every time we even just hang out with the kids and sit in the field and talk to them, there's more light in their eyes, there's more hope. That's what we're trying to bring to them, is a lot more hope, to show them that there's so much more out there than what they're being told in
their
schools.
Yeah, I mentioned at the top of the show, there's usually a group of 20 who comes over.
Yeah. Yes.
Right, and you have a group who are still in Bondo right now.
Yes, shout out to you guys. Love you.
Love you guys.
Are they watching you right now?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. They're in a little room,
yeah.
Huddled around a TV.
Oh, yeah.
Probably
so excited.
Right now,
yeah.
It's
probably
is that right?
Pages of the TV.
Probably, yeah.
Probably screenshotting all of our faces.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And how do you raise funds to do all this? I mean, so that's the obvious question.
Right.
Yes, we do what we do best. We perform, we sing, we dance.
Back in the States.
We do benefit shows. We do anything from singing at big events in Jacksonville to people who are tailgating to doing a big benefit show at a very nice theater in Jacksonville. So we have a full range.
And people pay for this?
Yes.
Let me hear what you got to sing. I mean, I'm sure you have a song somewhere.
We do.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
We got it.
Go.
Okay. All right. 5, 6, 7, 8.
We need a ticket for Africa. We're raising money for the way. we sure would like your sweet company to support our cause. What do you say? When we're gone, when we're gone, you won't miss us when we're gone. We're gonna take theater there, we're gonna show Kenya we care. Oh, you won't miss us when we're gone.
Oh, you're gonna show Kenya that you care.
Yes,
definitely.
Oh, that's sweet. And people pay money for this?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And how much? Okay, the first year you raised like $60,000 or something, right?
Yes. Yes.
But most of it is tickets, you know, because it costs quite a bit to come over.
Yes.
And then the rest is towards projects in Bonda, right, at the place?
And that, yeah, absolutely. And that's what is great about Theater on a Mission is we get to experience all of the culture of Kenya. We, you know, we get to tour the country and we get to help in other villages like the Kijiji Dialysis Clinic. We're able to donate money to get free dialysis for some patients, and now they are moving into a new building. We were able to supply the orphanage with a running water system from some of the money that we raised. So we've helped a lot, and we're really, really humbled by that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you want to do even more. We're gonna talk about the school you want to start in a little while. But tell me about some of the kids you've met there.
Oh my gosh. Don't get me started. I'll start crying. They are the most amazing kids I've ever met. Sorry.
No, go ahead. Go ahead.
I'm so humbled by them. I did not expect this to happen.
These kids that we meet, you know, we go over there and we think, you know, we're going to teach and we're going to, you know, they're going to learn so much from us. And it's really the opposite way. We learn so much from them. And that's so inspiring. And that's something that we didn't necessarily expect in the first trip. You know, we had our goals and our plans, and we go over there and we're like, wow, these kids are one in a million. And they're forever a special place in our heart. There's nothing that will change that.
Jackie, you want to add something?
It's such a beautiful give and take reciprocal relationship that we have with them. There's no teacher, no student. We're just all learning together.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Craig, is it a humbling feeling being out there?
Oh, the most. Because, like they said, you know, the kids almost give you more than what you give them. You know, we try to be role models for them and, you know, set good examples of, like, how to, you know, play nicely and share and do all this stuff. But, you know, at the end of the day, these kids they just warm your heart.
Yeah.
And that's, you know, that's the reason we keep coming back and will come back over and over and over again. Because
they're
these
our
kids.
Family. Yeah. They're our family.
That's what I don't understand. Help, forgive me here, but if I was you guys, I would have come that first year, put it on my CV, and moved on. And, you know, me being the cynic that I am.
We actually have a very unique story of why we did keep coming back is because we saw such an impact, and the kids were so open to what we were doing. And one of the children, they wrote us a letter, and the letter said something like, "I come back to the stage every day and practice being the lion in the show that you taught us." And so from then on, we were like, we have to keep doing this. We have to go back. So one trip turned into two, and then two turns into three, and then...
Now we're just counting.
Yeah. And then we're going to eventually move here, so...
Yeah. And that kid is the one in the picture there, isn't it? You want to show up that picture?
Sure.
Stano, yeah? Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah. Who's this kid?
This is Steven. Steven was probably one of the most special boys we had the honor of meeting, and he was 12 years old, and he really embodied the spirit of what Theater on a Mission loves to teach and show the kids. He embraced every part of Theater on a Mission. He wanted to be in every single group, participate in every activity, in every game, but...
What happened?
Unfortunately, when we came back from a previous trip, we found out that Steven had passed away. He was hit and killed by a car walking to school.
How old was he?
He was 12 years old. 12 years old. And so,
hit and run.
Yeah.
Hit and run. When you heard the news, Chelsea, how did that make you feel?
Devastated. Because that's my family. So.
Shame.
It was really hard for us, but we then quickly he then became our inspiration and our motivation for Theater on a Mission.
Yeah. And he was walking from the orphanage to the school. Local school.
Right.
He got hit by
The kids walk 3 miles to school and 3 miles back to school every day.
Wow. Does this motivate you even more? Does this make you guys want to do what you want to do even more?
Absolutely. Absolutely. We have the pleasure of being able to tell his story. And, you know, he might not be able to get to do that, but we have that honor, and that's really special to us. And that's why we keep going, and that's why we put so much into Theater on a Mission, because we know that there are so many other children just like Stephen that, you know, may not have the opportunity to do what they want to do, and, you know, things are cut short, but we're going to keep fighting for them in every way, shape, and form.
And when it's hard and we want to give up,
yeah,
we think of Stephen, and we say, you know, we're doing it for Stephen, we're doing it for Tony, we're doing it for John, we're doing it for Raymond, we're doing it for all.
We're doing it for everyone.
That's a good point, Craig, because a lot of people would have just given up. I mean, it's tough out there, and nobody would blame you for going back home, by the way. Nobody would blame you, but you're right. You know, there are tough days, aren't there?
Yes.
Yes.
And that's Stephen is our strength, you know.
Yeah.
Him and the kids, they're our foundation.
Yeah. There's 43 orphans right now,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And counting. I mean, they keep bringing more and more.
Yeah, they just got two new little ones.
And you all live in the center, in the orphanage?
Yes.
Yes.
Right?
They have a guest house for us that we are able to stay in.
Yeah, but you have the same conditions.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And we don't necessarily mind that. You know, if the orphanage doesn't have water, we don't have water. And we're taking showers outside and cold water, and that's okay. You know, if they can do it, we can do it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We're okay with that.
Yeah. Is it a pit latrine, or is it running water? I'm just asking, you know. Is it a long drop?
It's a... yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sure.
And you're getting attacked by bugs the whole time.
Yeah.
And
we're in there swatting with the broom, all the flies and spiders and other creatures that may come up. But, you know, we're not dead, so we're still here.
We make it out alive.
Do it.
They do it, so we do.
Yeah. You guys don't mind.
No.
It's the experience.
It's worth it.
It's all a part of the Kenyan experience.
We love it.
And you spend an average of a month every time you come, right?
Yes.
4 weeks plus.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That's incredible. I mean, I don't get it. I don't get it. We're going to take a break, come back. You've heard about schools being burnt across the country, right?
Yes.
Yes.
You must be asking, what's going on?
Yeah.
We're asking what's going on.
Yeah.
And here you are trying to build a school. You have plans to build a school.
Yes, sir.
A theater school.
Yeah.
I want to see those plans.
Okay.
Not right now. After the break.
After the break.
We're going to take a break. Inspiration Thursday, folks. Young folks from America coming to give back. All the way in Bondo, Siaya County. They're watching you. This is what we mean when we say, this is what the future of this country is all about. Everybody doing their bit to give back. On this Inspirational Thursday, amazing stories. 4 young American college kids coming back to Kenya every other summer, spending a month all the way in Bondo, Siaya County, in an orphanage to help kids get some self-esteem, get that feeling. And by the way, they're all orphans. No parents, no guardians. But these young college kids are here helping, giving them a voice. They've been doing this for the past 6 years. How about that, folks? Inspiration Thursday. And especially when you consider 70 schools have been burnt in Kenya to the ground the last 1 month. These Americans want to build a school. Think about that for a moment as the tweets keep coming in thick and fast. Oscar Kipkorea says, does Chelsea and the entire team know that they're inspiring some of us? They really are. Go team, go.
Wow.
Dylan Nyariki says, the Americans came and bonded in Bondo. They are doing massive great job. Japheth Muyaka says, I almost cried when I heard these inspirational songs and stories. Keep doing what you do. And then Jerry says, how would they not get support with such lovely voices back in Jacksonville? Let's hear that song again. Let's hear that song.
Again?
Go on.
Okay.
5, 6, 7.
We need a ticket for Africa. raising money for the way. And we sure would like your sweet company to support our cause. What do you say? When we're gone, you won't miss us when we're gone. We're gonna take theater there, we're gonna show Kenya we care, oh. You won't miss us when we're gone.
Oh yeah, there's a person called Buttercup. They say, wow, just wow. Well done. Twitter handles are @theater_mission @KoinangaJeff. The hashtag we're using tonight, giving back. That's right. So, you want to build a school?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
You want to build a school? What, a theater school? Arts and...
Performing arts.
Performing arts school.
Yes.
Right there in Bondo.
Yep.
That's right.
And you have the plans.
We do.
What do they look like? I'll hold your mic for you.
Thank you.
Stato?
This is our dream.
Right. Yep.
This is what, with a lot of hard work and a lot of years, this is what we want it to look like. We know in reality some things might not look that way, but that's our
that's our goal.
Yeah.
Dream school.
Dream big.
And this right here, this is a quadrangle and four sides, whatever, and then there's a little circle, a little ring thing there. What is that?
That is the Ring of Heroes, and that is actually a part of our fundraising method for getting this funding for the school. So what happens in the Ring of Heroes are there are stone pillars, and everybody who donates $1,000 or more gets their name engraved in one of those stone pillars. So that way, when the kids, it's the main entrance of the school, so that way when the kids walk into school, they're surrounded by the names and of everybody who made that possible and made this school happen for them.
And how many, what's the capacity for the school right now? You can put that down.
The capacity for the school is about 300 to 500 students.
Okay, and it's all performing arts.
It's gonna be basic curriculum as well, you know, basic school curriculum like they have now with the influence of the arts. And we're focusing on dance, visual arts, and singing.
And
theater.
And you're sourcing this money in the U.S. You're getting it from friends, strangers, bars, whatever, wherever you sing, churches.
Small businesses.
Small businesses,
family, friends, anyone that's willing to give us money.
You're doing it on your own over there.
Yes.
You don't want our help.
We would love your help. We would love your help.
Speak to the politicians in Bondo. I mean, they're there.
We would love to meet with you. If you want to meet with us, we'd more than willing.
I'm sure the governor, Ratzinger, he would love to meet you guys. And Senator Orengo. He's a cool guy.
We're very hopeful that the Kenyan community is going to show their support. I mean, because every time we come over here, they're always so inviting and welcoming to us. And, you know, we're excited to see what support they're going to show us. So we're very hopeful.
How soon would you like this thing, this project to get underway, Jackie? What's the timeline?
We want it to be
yesterday
up and running as soon as possible, but it'll probably be within the next 2 years that we'll definitely start building.
You think you can raise that kind of money, Craig, in the next couple of years?
We're definitely going to try our hardest.
While you're all in college?
Yes.
Blood, sweat, and tears.
How does that work?
It's a lot of late nights.
Yeah.
A lot of staying up till 2-3 o'clock in the morning. After we do our homework, we work on Theater on a Mission.
Danielle, I mean, look, a lot of people must be asking at this point, why do you do this? I mean, why bother?
Because we're changing lives, and we've seen that. We've seen that in the children that we're working with. We've seen that in their personalities. I mean, we've had one girl, Catherine, who we worked with in the very beginning, and who was very shy, very mild and meek, and didn't really know who she was in the beginning. And we were able to discover last trip that she had all these beautiful poems that no one had ever heard. And all she wanted was for somebody to listen, and we were that ear for her. And that right there, that's why we do what we do. Because if we can't always change their circumstances and we can't always change their situation, but we can give them moments of hope and we can give them that happiness or that one need that they want. And that's really important to us.
Yeah.
And now she's thriving at school. She's making great grades. She's amazing, amazing girl. Has grown so much.
Mm. You guys are the core team, right? This is the core team, basically.
Yes.
And the other 16 or so folks, do they rotate? Do you get fresh folks each time? How does that work?
Well, we definitely have a core group of people who definitely are involved in Theater on a Mission. And then we get new people coming every single trip. There has been new people coming and who are being inspired, just like us.
Are there those who come, Jackie? Are there those who come one time and they say, you know what? I ain't going back there, man. That long drop and those bugs.
Yeah, there are definitely people that come and realize it's not necessarily the place for them. It's not the place they're most comfortable, but I think they definitely gain from the experience.
Yeah.
And they'll show support for Theater
on the
Mission.
Oh, definitely.
Back home.
Back home.
Oh, definitely.
Back in the States. They'll always support us.
Speaking of back in the States, Greg, what do people think of what you all are doing back in the States? What do they think?
A lot of people love it, you know. They think it's awesome. They love what we're doing. They think it's inspirational. And some people, I mean, they don't like it because it's not like medicine or water or whatever, but we do that also, and that's what we're trying to get across, that we do both sides, you know. Mm-hmm. We help with their self-esteem, but we also help with their needs.
Yeah. Are there those who think you're a little crazy?
Most definitely.
Most definitely.
We take that one as a compliment.
Yeah.
So it's
and
that's the thing, you know, with criticism, is it only makes you stronger, and it only makes you stronger as a unit and as a group.
Yeah.
And we focus on the positive feedback, and no matter what you do, there's always going to be somebody who's not satisfied with what you're doing, and that's okay, but, you know, we're going to keep going on the positive path.
Yeah.
And keep doing what we're doing.
Yeah. Isn't this project a little too ambitious, Chelsea? Do you think it's a little ambitious?
Absolutely not. It's not. It's totally feasible. This is absolutely something that can be done, and I believe that 110%.
So I was saying earlier on, you all, the two of you, graduate next May.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
And one of the first things after you get your cap and gown and all that is jump on a plane and come back.
Yep.
That's right.
And settle there for a while.
Yeah.
Yep. Because we're going to be here in Kenya making sure that this school gets built and it's done right. And it's going to be amazing for these kids. I can't wait.
Seriously?
We're excited. Absolutely. We'll be here. This is our second home.
Yeah. Our hearts are here.
Right.
Our home may be back in Jacksonville and our families are there, but our hearts are here in Bondo.
Yeah.
In Kenya and in Bondo.
These children need us and we need these children. So.
Mm-hmm. Any regrets, Jackie, about coming? The first time you came, I mean, you came in the second round, right?
Yes, second
any
round.
Any regrets?
Not one. I regret not coming on the first trip. That's my biggest regret. Definitely. But no, everything I've gotten out of this experience has been amazing and so much more than I could have ever asked for.
You want to come back after you're done with college?
I plan to. I'm hopefully coming back in January with a professor of mine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We should definitely mention that. A really cool thing about this school is that we're going to have study abroad students. We've partnered with a bunch of colleges back home in the United States, and we're going to bring over study abroad students, educators, performers, dancers, singers, to come into the schools and teach master classes and workshops, so that there's this, it's sustainable and it's not going to lose the arts. So.
Craig, and when you finish your law degree, when you're done with that, are you gonna want to practice in Jacksonville, Florida, or are you gonna want to come back?
I'm always gonna come back to Kenya.
Yeah.
I just it's a piece of me, for sure. And I might not be able to go back as much as I want to, but I'm gonna, you know, come back as much as I can.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Someone needs to stay home.
And we have to have our support back in stateside.
There you go. There you go. When you guys first came to Bondo, did you know that Bondo is literally 20-minute drive from where Obama's father was born? Did you know that?
We actually did not know that, but we figured that out very quickly.
A place called Pogelo.
Yes.
About 20-minute drive from where you all are.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So when people saw you all,
they would say, please say hi to Obama when you get back home. As if, you know, we stayed right next door to him, which, you know, we had to explain. It doesn't quite work that way, but we'll try our best.
We can't just go knock on the White House
door. Yeah,
doors.
We can't just go knock on the White House door, you know, one day.
They keep telling you that?
Oh, yeah. We still get it. We got it as soon as we came.
Oh, yeah. Please say hi to Obama for me. Okay, we'll try. If I ever see him.
We'll try our best. That's
next
the
time.
First thing we're going to say.
Next time I see him.
How come Americans don't tell me, say hi to Uhuru when you go back? How come they don't?
I don't know.
Who knows?
Wow, that's incredible. Have you been to that part? Have you been to his grandmother's place?
No,
we have
Grandma
not.
Grandma Sarah Obama?
Not yet.
You should go sometime.
We should.
We'd love to.
Yeah.
We're so close. Might as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Wow. So 2 years, hopefully, the first phase.
Yes.
What are the other phases? Because there's more than one phase, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Go on.
Second phase would be adding in more arts areas, music, a band and orchestra.
Cinematic arts, creative writing, ad, film.
And then third phase is adding a primary school to feed into the secondary school.
So this is now just a secondary school?
Right, yes.
Uh-huh.
Right. And we find that it's an effective method to do it that way, so that way, you know, the arts aren't lost in between primary and secondary.
Yeah.
So that way, you know, those kids have, you know, the stability and the attention span to, you know, really absorb in the arts and then hopefully come back and be educators at that school.
Yeah. Right. Craig, so a couple of the kids have been able to get a scholarship, a very famous scholarship in Kenya called the Equity Wings to Fly. For smart, brilliant kids who come from disadvantaged backgrounds. Mm-hmm. Have you seen a change in the kids? Have you seen that these kids have really woken up and are shining and are flying?
Yes. See, thing is, they get inspired by us and by the scholarship. And it really motivates them, you know, to have, you know, because they come from nothing almost. And so to have no father, no mother, to have that, it's just an opportunity they can't get.
Yeah. How old is the oldest?
18 years old. And the youngest is about 3.5.
Yep. Yeah.
So the 18-year-old is now doing his final exams. Is that it? Or?
Yes.
Sort of.
He's kind of almost done, but he's still working with Theater on a Mission, hands-on, and he's amazing. His name's John. He's a great soccer player, and we love him. And he's really found a voice. You know,
oh, yeah.
I said this year, I was like, I've never heard him speak so much since we've came.
Really?
He's grown.
Yeah. Something really cool about John is when we do the plays, we perform in different schools. And so one of the places we perform is at their school. Mm-hmm. And so he came back to us and was like, I'm a rock star at my school now. I'm like, that's so awesome, John. That's
it makes
so awesome.
Us proud to see that they're proud of themselves.
Yeah. You think they're watching tonight? Are they? Oh, they have no TV.
They don't have.
They don't have
a
TV, unfortunately.
We hope so. We hope so. Yeah. We'll make sure
we'll
they
try
see
and show
somehow.
Them a video of it.
Yeah.
Hopefully, our members are taking a video of the TV.
They definitely are.
Okay. All right. Okay. Sweet. Now you said a really good soccer player.
Oh yeah,
yes. Captain is one of the best.
Of the soccer team.
Is he really really good, or is he just okay?
And we can if he's on the team and we're playing soccer back at the orphanage, we're losing all the way.
We always actually do a USA versus Kenya big soccer match with him.
And we
never
won.
Score.
I taught him everything he knows though. Let's just get that clear.
That's something really cool about this school too is we're not only going to have arts, we're going to have an organized sports program as well, because not every student is necessarily geared towards arts, so we want to have the sports outlet as well.
Yeah. All right, guys, I want to take another break, come back, and talk about how do the locals treat you all?
Wonderful.
Most
wonderful. Giving, caring, compassionate people are here right in Kenya.
Yeah.
You said that too quickly, Chelsea. Well done.
It's very true.
It's very true.
Yeah. You have a great support team.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And when you guys go back, who runs the place? Are there people to run the place as their team?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Tim and Kathy, who started the orphanage, live in Bondo currently, and they are amazing. They literally are saving these children's lives.
It's an American couple
who are the owners of the actual orphanage, and they show us constant support throughout the year. Are always in communication with us. When are you coming back? Let us know what you need. Well, also, you know,
and they packed up, left America, and now live in Bondo.
Absolutely.
They literally sold everything they owned.
Right.
Everything they owned to come to Kenya and run this orphanage for these kids.
Right.
Wow.
They have the biggest hearts out of anyone I know. Truly.
They were our foundation, you know, Foundation Stone Children's Center. They were our foundation, so.
Wow.
Yeah.
All right.
We couldn't do it without them.
Yeah. You're about to cry again, you know that.
Yeah.
Gonna take another break. Keep tweeting at theater_mission at Koinange Jeff. The hashtag giving back. Listen up, people. Listen up carefully. These folks, 21-year-olds, can come all the way from Jacksonville, Florida, and give back to us. What is our Jeff Koinange live at the Villa Rosa against Pinsky on this Inspiration Thursday. Amazing young Americans average age 21, been coming to Kenya for the last 6 years in Bondo, Siaya County specifically, and their dream is to build a school. Chelsea Kane, Danielle Glenn, Jackie Jones, and Craig Kane, part of a team of 20 Americans who come every other year, and they're gonna make this their mission to build a school, to build an arts and performance center in Bondo. Tweets coming in very thick and very fast. The Twitter handles are @theater_mission. Mine is @Kwinanga. Jeff, the hashtag giving back. So, Wildlife Warrior, that's the guy's name. He says, while Kenyan students are busy torching their schools, the American students are busy building schools in Kenya. Paul Peru says, young brains with bigger hearts, dreams, and visions. Totally inspired. God bless you. Cynthia Nyongesa says, no dream is so huge that it can't be achieved as long as the heart is willing. Beautiful. John Cargo says, the best investment is giving back to the community and in a child. You will leave a legacy many years after you are gone. And then here's a question from K Money. He says, are they married?
No, we're not.
No, we're not.
We're actually all single.
Okay. We had a while for
I'm
that
not married,
one.
K Money. I'm still single. I promise.
Okay, there's your answer. Everybody wanted to know that question. I guess K was just voicing
brave
the thoughts
to ask
of many
it.
People out there. The land. I mean, obviously, this is a big project. Where are you going to get the land from? I mean, have you thought about all these things?
Yes, we have. Well, actually, we're going to buy land right across the street from the orphanage so the kids didn't have to walk so far. But when we were trying to figure out who to buy it from, the person who was trying to sell it to us didn't actually own the title. So we had a little bit of a setback with the land, but that's okay. Maybe it was a blessing in disguise because that area is struggling with water. Mm-hmm. So we definitely want to have land that has access to water. Working on it.
And if it's a little further away than we had anticipated, that's okay as well because we are providing dorms as well right. In this secondary school for the children. So they won't have to walk back and forth from wherever they live or you know, miles and miles away.
Yeah.
Home.
Yeah.
And just out of curiosity, if someone out there has a piece of land, what are we looking at, Jackie? How much land are we looking at?
So far, to start out, about 50 acres, if not more, because we want room to expand.
Right.
Okay, go on.
This is the layout so far.
This is the whole school and the soccer fields and volleyball court and future middle school.
Yep.
Yes.
That's all.
This is pretty ambitious, Greg. I mean, this is no easy. There's no mean feat.
I mean, when we get struck with the tragedy of, you know, what happened to Stephen, this is the outcome of that. You know, we really want to help.
Yeah.
And this is the best way that we came up with, and so this is what we want.
This is your giving back.
Oh yeah.
Definitely. Someone did these plans for free, didn't they?
Yes. They did. Biden Hall Architects back home. We were shocked. We sat in that meeting with them, and we were extremely speechless. Just didn't know what to say. Didn't know, you know, just sitting there like, why us? Like, why would you want to do this? Like, we, you know, and they have just been, I mean, working restlessly in hours and hours on these plans and to prepare us for this. And we cannot thank them enough.
So grateful.
Did any one of you ever think you would end up in Africa? Any one of you? In your wildest dreams?
No.
No. The first trip, I was actually convinced I wasn't going. I told everybody. My mom was like, Craig, you're going to Africa? I'm like, nah, not going.
It was a hologram.
No, I don't think any of us pictured this, but it has been probably the best surprise we have ever had.
Mm. Would you recommend this to folks back home?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely. Right. 100%.
And when you recruit, I don't know how you do this, when you get the next round of people, what do you tell them? I mean, how do you convince people?
We share our hearts with them. Mm-hmm. And if our hearts match, then that's amazing. And we want them to be on our team. So that's all we really can do is share our hearts with them and share our vision and our story. And
do people turn you down?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes. Of course. Of course they do. But that's okay. Because you know, the people who lift us up outweigh the bad ones. So yeah, we're just fine with that.
And I think as our trips continue and as we get bigger and bigger, more people, we don't have to convince them anymore. Right. They ask to come. They say, I have this big idea for you. Can I help?
Yeah.
And can I come to see the kids?
Yeah.
They're inspired by us.
Craig, you guys have a website. If people want to get more information,
yes,
get to know more about Theater on a Mission, what is it?
That is theateronamission.org.
And theater with an R-E, not E-R. Yes.
Exactly.
Right?
That's right.
R-E.
On Twitter and a Facebook and an Instagram.
Oh, hello.
Lots of social media.
Clearly. And if people want to help, is there a way when you get on the website, is there?
There's a big donate button.
Okay, okay.
Right on the front page. Mm-hmm. And you can donate any amount.
As much as.
Right. And I've seen some of your stories on YouTube. I mean, you guys, the stuff that you do back home, it's pretty commendable.
Thank you. We are so humbled to be here, to be sitting with you right now. For anyone to just listen to our story and to share our story, we are so grateful and so thankful for you guys.
Oh, look at you. You know, I was saying earlier on, if we can, sometimes we don't know how lucky we are with the things that we have.
Absolutely.
And then you all come from 8,000 miles away and you're doing what you're doing and you're staying in the conditions you're staying in. I mean, what excuse do we have? Who are we? So tell me about the chicken.
Well, earlier you asked us how the community receives us. And
yes,
we went to visit some widows and just some locals around the area. And I remember walking up to this one house, and this lady goes into this room, and I hear all this squawking and cracking and everything. And so she comes out, and she hands me a live chicken. A live chicken, and boy, was that a cultural experience for me.
Well, did you grab it?
Oh, I grabbed it, and I'm just standing there like, okay. But that was just such an honored gift for her to give me, and I didn't realize that in the moment, but I quickly realized when...
It happened again.
Yeah.
We quickly realized when, you know, we went to go visit, you know, smaller villages and people, and here comes another chicken, and then we're riding an hour and a half on the bus with a live chicken. And, it was such a surprise to us. And we were like, why do we have a chicken? And then we realized, you know, that what people have is all they have.
Yeah.
And when they want to give that to you, that means
a lot. That's a big deal.
Oh, yeah.
Big deal.
So how did it taste?
Good.
We don't.
The
we like to we think that it's still
chicken.
Alive and has a great life.
No, it tasted good.
Well done. And the local delicacy of that area.
Yeah.
Omana.
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 Skumawiki.
Ugali.
Ugali.
Again, all a part of the experience.
Oh, yeah.
You don't seem very excited about it.
We're excited the first day, and then you get to, like, the fifth day.
In a
and
row.
And then the seventh day, and you've eaten a lot of Skumawiki, and you're like,
yeah.
All right.
I could go for some pizza.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, sweet.
But that's okay.
Yeah.
We're thankful for all of it.
It's worth it.
It's all worth it.
We love it.
Worth it. If we have to sacrifice some pizza for some Skumawiki, so get over to these kids,
I
we'll
do it
in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
But that's the question a lot of people are probably asking right now. I mean, why you guys? What makes you guys this way? Because, you know, that's not what we think of most Americans.
Right.
And most Americans would not want to do what you people are doing. Why you all? Tell me, help me.
For me, I really think it is because of my mom. She's raised me just to be compassionate, caring, and I see that through her. And then I am motivated by these people sitting next to me. That's why, is because of the people in my life and the people around me.
Yeah, Danielle.
I think it's the children. It's being able to sit hands-on with the children and learn from them, because I know I wouldn't be sitting here with anybody. I wouldn't be in Africa for the third time if I didn't have that person in my life that inspired me and said that I can do what I say I can do, and that somebody believes in me.
Mm.
And if I didn't have that person, I wouldn't be here today. And so I want to give that to those kids, and they deserve that. They deserve much more than that.
Yeah. Jackie.
I definitely agree with both Chelsea and Danielle. Shelly Kane pulled me into this one day when I was just in my high school hallway, and I've been hooked ever since. Her and my mom just inspire me to be such adventurers and to go out and help as many people as I can. And the people sitting next to me just have my back always, and I know that.
Great.
For me, Jeff, it's knowing that we make a difference. Yeah. That's what really keeps me going, and I think keeps a lot of these guys going. Is when you see the smiles on their face, and they run up and give you a big hug. You know, that's what does it for me.
Yeah, and you've been inspired even more, Craig. You want to take this to India.
Yes.
You want to take this mission there at some point.
Yes.
Right now.
We want to make, not just me, but Theater on Mission wants to make this a global effort. We want to help not just Kenya, all of Africa, if we can, you know. We want to help India. We've been to Costa Rica already.
Plans for Haiti.
Haiti. You
know. Yeah. Plans for Haiti. Yeah. We really want to make a difference.
Yeah.
We want to branch out, expand.
Our motto is making a difference one act at a time. And so Kenya grabbed our hearts from the beginning. And so we're starting one school here. And so one act at a time, one kid at a time, one school at a time. And Kenya's the first. And what an honor that is. Yeah. For us. So
America has gone through a really tough period in the last couple of years, maybe several years. Do you wish more Americans would see what you see, feel what you feel, experience what you experience, to appreciate what's over there? Do you feel that way?
Yeah, I mean, we always want to just constantly raise awareness about Theater on a Mission and what we're doing, and because we know that it helped us grow as individuals and our perspective and outlook on life and future plans. So, but we're hopeful, you know, that we can touch the lives of our community as well as the Kenyan community.
It's good stuff, man. I still can't get over it. The other 16 or 15 who are in Bondo right now, some of them, is it their first time in Kenya?
Oh, yes.
Everyone there.
Everyone watching.
It's their first trip?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
What did they think? What were their thoughts?
Actually, this team has done surprisingly well.
Yeah?
They have been amazing. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. They have been with us every step of the way. They are just the most creative people, and they have embodied the kids, what Theater on a Mission is all about, first trip or not, they are a part of this team and they are in our hearts just as much as us sitting here. We're all speaking together. We're a team.
Yeah.
And this team is so, you know, it's just, we offer so many different things and we bring so many different things to the table. I mean, we have Chiselle back home. She's up 7 o'clock in the morning with the kids doing yoga and taekwondo, and, you know, and they love it. They love it. They love that activity, and, you know, we have come with so many different things, but have created something wonderful, and that's great.
Okay, everything is wonderful, but there's got to be some things that are not so wonderful. Jackie, what's the worst thing about being out there, other than the long drop?
Other than the long drop? Really? I don't know. I think that might be one of the... the bugs.
Yeah. The bugs.
The bugs.
What about malaria? Aren't you all afraid of getting malaria? I mean, no?
Malaria.
We're on our medication. We'll be all right.
Yeah.
We got medication.
Yeah.
For me, it's the showers.
That's refreshing.
Yeah, it's
cold.
And it's cold.
Yeah.
But
it's freezing cold.
Yeah.
Oh, most of the time. For me, it's the dust. All the red dust. It gets everywhere.
It gets everywhere.
And, you know,
every crevice.
We were able to get cleaned up for the show, but we still got a whole layer of African dust we have to get through. So
I'm actually paler than this.
Yeah, so it's, you know, your feet are never clean, and we're working through it. But
the red dust of Africa.
Yeah.
It doesn't leave you.
You come home with it.
With it, yeah.
For like 3 weeks.
It takes a while.
Yeah.
It comes home in your stuff.
Great. Worst thing.
Worst thing.
Is the beer too warm? I'm kidding.
No.
I'm kidding.
I love Tusker. Listen, shout out to Tusker. Worst thing for me, I would have to agree with the shower too.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
It just drips on you, like this, and you're just like.
There's no pressure. No water pressure.
So coming to Nairobi must have been great for you guys.
Oh, it's a little vacation.
Warm shower.
Yeah, we've never done this before, so this is nice.
Yeah. There's 15 in Bondo are listening to what you're saying right now.
Sorry, guys.
They're probably like, okay, yeah, whatever.
But we love you.
Also, no Wi-Fi.
Oh,
we're fine
without
that.
Me.
Yeah.
First world
we
problems.
Deal.
First world problems.
Yeah, we're a little disconnected, but that's okay. Oh. And we like that.
I think it's refreshing.
We miss our family and stuff.
Yeah. But we don't. We don't get to be bothered by, you know, the rush of social media and, you know, all of the stress that can bring sometimes. So we like that. We like to be able to disconnect for a while and really connect into the kids.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Focus. Distractions there. None. Whatsoever.
But Bondo Town, there is Wi-Fi.
In the town, that's very sort of. Spotty.
It's not strong.
Not strong Wi-Fi. It takes like a few minutes to load.
Yeah.
One page.
You need to speak to that governor there. What is he doing?
Hopefully he's watching. And he's on our website.
Yeah,
he's doing it. He's on Wi-Fi scrolling through.
Oh, yeah.
If you weren't doing this, Chelsea, what would you be doing?
Just being a student, an average student.
Yeah.
That's what I'd be doing, just being in school. But I get to do school, and I get to do this. Mm. So it's the best of both worlds.
Danielle, if you weren't doing this, if you'd never been convinced by your girlfriend here to come over.
I don't know if I'd be as happy as I am today. I definitely wouldn't be as happy. This is my place in this world, and this is where I belong. And I don't know. I can't ever imagine myself not doing this.
I'll never forget something Danielle told me once, which was, in this world, as a student from Jacksonville, Florida, you can feel so small. But Danielle told me that when she came over here.
Don't do it.
She felt so big. And that's what really,
And it's we are just students sometimes, and we deal with our own struggles of finding out who we are as individuals and stuff. And it's hard to have confidence for such a large body of children. And when you come over and you get somebody who hands you and says, "I need you," that does it.
Yeah.
That does it.
Are you guys gonna make us all cry now? I mean, what you wanna do?
No, tears of joy.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Hope. Jackie, what about you? If you weren't doing this?
I don't know what I'd be doing, because even my major at school is centered around theater on a mission. And so I'd probably be just doing my gen eds in college and trying to figure it out. We'd see what happens.
Yeah. Craig.
I have no idea. Like, I'm trying to think, like, maybe I'll do this, maybe I'll do that.
Right.
Jeff, I have no idea.
Wow.
I think I'd be lost almost.
Really? Yeah. So this has been a life changer. I mean,
definitely.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Totally. Yeah.
It's definitely what we're called to do.
Definitely. And it's created such a family in all of us.
Yeah. What do you tell Kenyans who, let's say they want to help, they want to, you know, jump in, they love what you guys are doing, and they want to be a part of it? What do you tell them?
Come
Please
on.
Reach out to
Go
us.
Our website.
Yes. Social media, our website, theateronamission.org, Theater on a Mission, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
Right.
Please reach out to us. We'd love to speak with you, and we'd love your support and help.
Right.
Join our email list. Mm-hmm. You can do that on the website, and you can submit questions and ways to be part of the team if you'd like.
And if you have any questions or anything, we're open.
Yeah.
You
know?
Yeah. We love to connect with the Kenyan community.
Yeah, when you have Wi-Fi.
Yes, when we have Wi-Fi.
We're here in Kenya for another week, so we might not be able to get back to you until we get back to the States and get rid of some jet lag.
Great, guys, we've got a couple of minutes to go. Some closing thoughts. Craig, I'm going to start with you. This is your camera over here. Some closing thoughts for you.
Thoughts. First of all, I just want to thank Jeff for this amazing opportunity. And if you want to help us, please do. We can need all the support you can give us. And I want to thank my mom and the whole entire team for coming over here and doing this and seeing the vision that we see.
Great, well done. Jackie, same camera.
Along with Craig, I'd like to thank everyone who's ever supported us, anyone who's been on past trips, and definitely the country of Kenya for being so supportive and so welcoming. I mean, sometimes people on the streets are surprised to see us, but it's always, we always get a thumbs up, we always get a high five, and that's everything we needed. It's that confidence boost, and we hope to do that for the kids, and that's really what it's all about.
Danielle.
I'm speechless at, you know, being surrounded by such a wonderful group of people. I can't thank Shelly enough for sticking behind us, my parents back home for believing in me and believing in our team, the children, the staff at the orphanage, Tim and Kathy, everybody, and God for blessing me with this opportunity just to be in this on this team. Thank you for giving me my place in this world.
Nice. Chelsea.
I would love to thank Danielle.
She
believed in me when no one else did. And Theater on a Mission would not be Theater on a Mission without her. Yeah. And I would like to thank our team, any team members that have gone on a trip, anyone who has supported us back home, you, Jeff, for sharing our story, and my mom.
Good stuff. Love it. There's a guy who... you know what a border border is, right?
Yes.
You have
they're everywhere.
Okay. They're everywhere.
All right. Wilson is a good friend of mine. He's a border border writer around town, and he watches this show. He loves Inspiration Thursday. So he says, Jeff, it's so encouraging to watch these young ladies who understand the real definition of love and caring for kids. Please tell them to keep up the good work. God bless them.
Thank you.
Wilson.
Thank you so much.
Border border guy. Appreciates what you guys are doing. Tweets have been coming in so thick, so fast, guys. I can't even keep up. Roy, there's a guy called Roy Guitar. He says, development is an attitude. We Kenyans seem to have a negative attitude towards helping those less fortunate. Okay. I want to ask you to comment. Guys, it's been a pleasure. Wish you
the pleasure
best.
Is ours.
Thank
Wish you.
You
all
the
Thank best you so going much. Back home.
And you all are coming back next year, right?
Oh yeah.
After you graduate.
That's right.
As soon as possible.
We'll be here.
And then you too.
Oh yeah.
Fantastic. Eventually, yeah.
Keep it up. What you guys are doing. I mean, you may not realize it, but you're changing lives. One act at a time, right?
One act at a time.
That's the
motto. And one child at a time as well. Well done. Giving back. Thanks so much for joining us tonight. It's been a great Inspiration Thursday. Young, 21-year-old Americans coming all the way, 8,000 miles to make a difference, one act at a time, all the way in Bondo, Siaya County. What a way to give back. And they're doing it genuinely, and they love what they're doing, and they're encouraging anyone who wants to help. They're determined to build that school, performing arts, and then phase two and phase three, they want to make Bondo their home. Imagine that. Think about it. What a show. I'm running out of words to say. Keep tweeting at @theater_mission, @KoinangaJeff, the hashtag giving back. That's exactly it. Next week is a new week, new show, new guests, new themes. But the one thing that's always consistent are those three letters on the keyboard. Do you know that? They follow each other? J-K-L. That's it. Jeff Koinange live right here on Kenya's television network, KTN. So, folks, let's wrap up. I want to hear that song once more.
Okay.
Three, two, one.
We need a ticket for Africa. We're raising money for the way. And we sure would like your sweet company to support our cause. What do you say? When we're gone, you won't miss us when we're gone. We're gonna take theater there. We're gonna show Kenya we care. Oh, you won't miss us when we're gone.
Right.